It's good to be here.
Good
to see
you all.
And God bless you
all.
Now, this morning I will first talk about how to raise up people to serve God.
Because
people who are willing to serve God are the, you know, the strongest one, the pillars of the church.
Now you can
draw a pyramid. You can draw it on your notes, a pyramid.
Okay,
at the bottom are the people who are not steady with Jesus Christ, who are not steady to the church.
And then
the next level are people who are more steady, but they still have a lot of weaknesses.
And then the
next level are people who are more devoted, who love the Lord and have some relationship.
And then
the next level are people who can manage the problems in their life, that they will take care of problems in their life and they have, you know, purpose in serving God.
And then
the highest one are the ones who have strategy to serve God.
Now, I want
to say this too. Even pastors don't necessarily all have strategies.
Because, you
know, I used to be a pastor who said, you know, one time I heard about strategy, I said, every week I just do service and Bible study and visitation, and what else do I do? What strategy can I have? But after I was revived by the Holy Spirit, I can see that I can raise up some people to love God more.
It's
like in the parable of the sower.
And there are
four kinds of soil.
And
the last kind is the good soil. Now even the good soil, some, you know, bear fruit 30 times, some 60 times, one 100 times. After I experience the Holy Spirit, I can feel the fire of the Holy Spirit, you know, the Holy Spirit pushing me to love God more and find way to serve God better. When I pray for people, I found that there were different responses. Some people kept coming every week and say, please pray for me, I have sickness, I have worries, I have doubts, I have family problems.
And
I kept telling them, you know, you, when you look at Jesus more and not to look at the problems, then you find that you have more strength to overcome the problems. But they kept telling me, oh, my husband yelled at me yesterday and I'm unhappy. And I thought about my problems overnight and I could not sleep, and so this morning I came very late to church.
Now
Now I'm sure you have come across people like that. Now it seems that when these people, when they keep looking at their problems, it is very hard for them to overcome the problems.
Yeah.
And what happens, they are overwhelmed by the problems. And also they don't look at Jesus, they don't have a close relationship with Jesus, they don't have faith in Jesus. And so they cannot get strength from God. And then they have all headache, backache, family
problems,
emotional problem. And some of them even have to depend on emotional drugs. And I found that for people who depends on these drugs, it's very difficult to get over it.
Yes.
But I've known people who, you know, have been using these drugs. And then they came to the meeting to experience the Holy Spirit. And they responded to God. Now, yesterday I said that the experience in the Spirit has to affect our mind and our soul. Now some people just experience the Holy Spirit in the Spirit. They feel better when we pray for them. But it doesn't go to the mind. When they have problems, they cannot discern the problem and they cannot discern the problematic people.
And
they keep on being affected by these problematic people. Now, in another session, I will talk about how to handle problematic people, how we can turn off problematic people and love them, but turn off their negative words. But, you know, in another session. And I'm telling you, there are some people, even though they have been taking, you know, mental medicine, but they learn it to keep looking at Jesus, have a close relationship with Jesus, and not to look at the problems. Now we handle the problems and turn off the problem, turn off the effect of the problems on us. It doesn't mean I don't know the problem. We know the problem and then we turn off the problem so it won't affect us. And then she noticed this person, one person I have in mind, she noticed how she experienced the joy of the Lord and peace of the Lord when we are worshiping and praying. And also how she can intentionally turn off negative effects on her. And then she kept improving. And I always tell people, even if you improve a little bit one day, don't say you have a lot you haven't improved. But look at the little improvement and say, thank God for that. And we can say to ourselves, you're doing well today. And you can keep improving. Now when people keep looking at the positive sides, they have more strength. Also, when I pray for people, I always tell them, you know, how you experience the Holy Spirit. In the future, you can pray for other people to experience the Holy Spirit. You can be used by God to raise up people to serve God and, you know, and bring people to Jesus. And I always ask this question when I, even after I bring them to Jesus. Are you willing to bless other people one day? I always ask them this question after I bring them to Jesus. You are blessed by Jesus today. You can bless other people. You experience a peace and a love and a power of the Holy Spirit. Do you want to help other people experience the Holy Spirit? Now some people answer yes, but they don't act on it. They forget about it. But some people, you know, they say yes and then they keep working on it. Now here I'm talking about spotting the people who have the heart to be changed by God. Now for myself, not only that, I spot the pastors who are more motivated to change. Who has the heart to be changed by God, and who has a heart of revival to the whole land, not just his own church. Who has a heart of God, always think of what does God want me to do? Now there are people who want things done for them. But there are some people who has the heart of God, they love God and they love to do the will of God, and not for their own benefit. And then they have the heart to bless other people without bringing any benefit to themselves. They are willing to bless other people. Let me tell you, I haven't found many people like that.
Yes.
On the top of this pyramid are people who have the heart to follow God, who have found the strategy of God, who has a heart to bless other people. Now, I want to tell you that the strategy has to come from God.
No,
if people just want to do their own things, they might be blocking the work of God. You know, for instance, if the way we raise up people is by pressure, you have to follow God and obey God. Now, if people obey you, they don't go very far. But if we let them see how God loves you, you're very precious. And God's love and power is for you all the time. God has a wonderful plan in your life.
He can
and he can give you the spiritual gifts and the supply needed for you to serve God more. And any little things he has done well, I would say, you are doing well. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Even though he might have weaknesses, Now I will help the person to face his problems and overcome it step by step. This is not change instantly. But so long that he keep working on it, even though he has not overcome all his problems, it's okay. When he has improved a little bit, I will praise him. And I would sometimes ask him to share in front of group what God has done through him. So that he gained more and more confidence in God. And he believes that he can do greater things for God. And I also will lead him to listen to the voice of God. What does God move him to do? What does God, you know, what teachings God has given him? How has he responded to God? When he responds to the voice of God, I will tell him this is very good because this is how you can grow. Now gradually he finds a strategy even inside the church. Now for each person, your spiritual gift is different and your strategy will be different. It has to come from God. Now for those people on the top of the pyramid who has the heart of God, who wants to follow God, and who has received strategy from God and he follow it faithfully, and he has put down his selfish desires, these are the people who can bring revival to all places. Now, even some pastors, if they just look at, oh, my church members are not good, oh, they don't listen to me, it's very difficult. I have burdens in ministry. Then it's very hard for the pastor to go any further. But if the pastor says, it's God's ministry, even though there are a few people today in the church, it's okay, I will do my best to bless them. It's God's work, so it's not me to put pressure on myself. I can relax in God and trust in God and serve with joy. Even though there are a few people in the church, if I can give them positive effects, positive influence. And then they came today, and then they see that the pastor is very free, and then they get the strength from the Lord. Even the few people now have big influences on other people. And then they see the pastor is relaxed. It's joyful and peaceful. And look at all the positive things of people. And encourage the people. The people get encouraged.
Mm.
Now, when I'm away from Hong Kong, my members in Hong Kong, they are counseling people and praying for people. They're leading worship, they're playing a piano. And they are preaching. And they are followed by the people. Because I have given them the sense of responsibility for the church and the organization. It is their ministry. Not just mine.
Yes.
So they have a sense of responsibility. And I praise them for what they've done.
Yes.
And they have the motivation to do better.
That's right.
And then among the people, I will spot the ones who have, you know, that they're using the spiritual gifts and finding the strategy for God. There are some who have stronger gifts and who are more willing, who love God more. These are the people I want to raise up more. So in a church, it's first very important to spot people who really have the heart for God. And then for the lay Christians here today, you can examine your heart. You can examine your heart. Do you have the heart for God? Or do you have the heart just on your needs and your problems? Do you want to go high in the plan of God? Now I want to say this. Not everyone is a minister. I'm not saying you all become ministers. I'm saying you, we are all witnesses of Jesus, and we are all encouragers of other people and build up other people's spiritual life. No matter what little thing you have done for Jesus, Jesus is very happy. As Jesus said, even when you give a cup of cold water to a little one, God is very happy and it will give you reward. And when you seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, all these things will be added to you. Now you might be having a job working for some boss. You find good bosses and bad bosses. But God is the best boss.
Yes.
He knows your heart. He helps you. He lifts you up. He looks at all the good things you have and He remembers it and He rewards you. And then if you love Him and follow Him, your life will go higher and higher. Now I have this heart that from the Bible. The more we follow God, the more blessed we are. That's what the Bible teaches. Even 1% that we don't obey God, that 1% will bring a lot of destruction. For instance, if someone doesn't like someone else, the destruction is not just in a relationship with this person. It will affect the whole person. It will affect how God looks at us. So any problem, any sins we have in our heart, now could be for some people, they say, oh, who is my future spouse? Oh, let me look at him or her. Is this the one?
Oh no, and I won't know.
If the heart is like that, not only that part of the mind is affected, it affects the whole relationship with God. And it makes it hard for this person to find the one prepared by God for him or her. If you really love God, God knows who is the right person for you, and He has already planned the person for you. So if you just say, Lord, guide me, I don't want to follow my own desire. And even if someone likes me, I have to ask God, is this the person? Now, for some people, if someone says, oh, I like you, in Chinese we have this expression. Even when he's eating, if someone says, I like you, he would, you know, throw up the food and say, yes, 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 yes. It's like saying, that's the best thing. But for God's blessing, they don't respond like that. They think, well, God is church. Many people think God is church, God is boring sermons. I mean, many people think like that. Many people think God is, oh, praying, oh, reading the Bible, doing all these things. That is a very negative view of God. And some people think of God as someone always accusing them. You're no good, no good, I don't like you. Now that is not true. God really has a very loving heart, a broad heart. If we just have a little heart to love God, God is already very happy. When we start to do little things for God, God is very happy. And if we really seek God's kingdom, that means I want more people saved. That's the first meaning. I will bring more people to believe in Jesus. And the second is, the Lord is my King in my heart. That is seeking the kingdom of God. God is the King in my heart. You know, every ship has a captain to guide this ship. We all have a guiding system for our life. We all have one. But some people's guiding system is find more girls, find more guys. Some people's guiding system is find a better job, find more money, and more enjoyment.
I will
tell you, not too many people have God as the total guy and say, whatever God says, I will obey right away. I hope you have this heart. When you have this heart, God really likes you. For high is the heaven is above the earth, so great is his love toward people who really honor him and fear him and put him as the Lord. And you lack nothing good. Now I hope when you think of God, you say, God is so creative. He creates so many different plants and animals. God is so happy because whenever I praise him, I can experience his joy. God is so wise because he can give me wisdom. God is so powerful because he can change the worst sinners. God
is so powerful.
So I hope you all, when you think of God, you really like him. Now, the people who like God a lot, it's easy for you to experience the Holy Spirit. When you pray and say, God, I like you, I like you, I love you, you can experience joy every time you pray. Now, yesterday, some people began to have joy of the Lord. You treasure it as I treasure it in
1998.
Because I treasure God, I treasure the joy of the Lord when I experienced that in 1998. When I experienced the joy of the Lord in 1998, I was very thankful and happy. And I continue to praise God to keep the joy. Hallelujah. And when I was taking the bus home, all the way I was doing this. The reason is I treasure God and every gift from God.
Amen.
It's not for my enjoyment. Although I enjoy the joy of the Lord, but I want to follow God's will.
Ask
them to help you. They know better which one works. Just now the one works earlier. Okay. So I want to keep this joy of the Lord so that all the time I'm joyful. And also when I pray for people, people can experience the joy of the Lord. So for everything, my heart, my goal is God. I hope you are like that. When you are like that, God knows it. God won't miss you. He will remember you and he will bless you. I see so many special gifts, blessings from God. Like this time I came to Uganda. I met the 10th person who have dreamed of my ministry or of me before I went to that place. The 10th person. When we went to the other village, there was a woman who shared. She had a vision that a visitor is coming. And then she asked and then found out that I was coming. And then she came and she was the 10th person who have dreamed or have visions about me before they knew me. Now I say all this not to glorify myself. I'm saying everyone who loves God, God sees your heart.
Yeah.
Now, if you look on the internet, YouTube or Facebook for the pastor, YIP,
Facebook,
and you see many Chinese videos, but you also see many English videos. And you look for South Africa, Pastor Yip, South Africa,
Pastor Yip.
And then you see one woman who saw, you know, who had a dream and saw me in a dream and experienced the power of God in the dream. She told me that in a dream she was chased by someone and she was very much afraid. And she ran to a house. And then she saw there were Chinese inside. And when she went inside, she saw me. I asked her, "Can I pray for you?" And she said, "Yes." And the moment I touched her, she experienced joy and love in the dream. So powerfully, she woke up laughing with joy. And then the same day, I went to her place. And then when she saw me, I prayed for her. She also experienced the joy and the love of God. And also the teaching is the same about the joy and the love of God. And the face was the same, that she knew that it was, she saw me in a dream. What I want to say is, if you really love God, God knows it and He honors you. And He opens the way for you in different countries and or different ways that you can bless people. And if you really have a quiet heart, let me tell you, when I pray, I put down all the burdens and worries. I just think of God loving me. God is happy that I come to Him. And I love God very much. Now this is what I talked about yesterday. The prayer of grace is what He, how He loves me and He wants to bless me. And prayer worship that I respond to God, I love God and honor God and praise Him. So I just put down all my burdens. And I noticed that in the prayer, God will keep giving me ideas of teaching and or what to do. And 2 days ago when I was praying, I got two ideas of two sermons and I wrote them down on the cell phone. Now all this teaching you saw me give to you, actually most of them I received them from the Lord. And I hope that you will say, yes, the ones who love God most and really honor God are the one who will be used by God greatly and have great influence on the land. So as pastors in the church, we don't just preach and teach and visit. We want to find out how the people are. When we pray for people, we'll tell them they can be used by God. Are you willing to be used by God? And then we can discern the response of the people. Some people really respond very well. Because they will respond with their actions afterwards. They will tell you how they are improving. And how they have the heart on God. How they handle the problems in life. I want to say that in a church, the strategy is raise up these people more. Now, we only have 24 hours a day. Now, we could be very busy helping people who always have needs. I have needs, I have sickness, I have problems, I have burdens. I help these people too. I also have my, you know, team members to help them. But my energy is mostly put in the people who have the heart for God. So we look at the whole life in these people. If we notice that they really have the heart for God, now they have, might have certain problems. I don't have to rebuke them. I just guide them to face the problems. Like Jesus, he helped Peter when Peter was about to deny him 3 times. Jesus did not rebuke him. Jesus just guided him. Jesus said, I pray for you so you won't lose your faith. When you turn back, strengthen your brother. Now, even when Peter said to Jesus, don't go to Jerusalem. Now, Jesus was speaking to Satan. Satan, get behind me. He did not say, Peter, get behind me. And he was building up Peter. Now, the word, you know, heavy accusation is only pointed toward the Pharisees and the people who don't repent. For the people who repent, we want to strengthen them, build them up. Now, let me tell you, I will not close my eyes to the problems of my team members. When they have problems in their life, I would guide them to understand it and guide them to grow in it, to face these problems.
Yeah.
Now, even for Washington here, I guided him and told him how he can go higher and higher. What he needs to avoid, and how he can be used by God more. My eyes are open. I don't just say, well, this person wants to follow me, then he must be good. I want to strengthen him and help him overcome his problems. And I have sessions with these leaders to build them up. So what I want to say to pastors are, the most important strategy in a church is to find the people who have the heart for God. And your message to the people always have this invitation. Do you want to follow God more? Do you want to love God more? Do you want to follow this perfect will of God? Do you want to be used by God greatly? And you can start by smiling at people.
Oiza kutani kila mku mwenyeza wa antu choka. Uweleza tukutwa nila wala.
Caring for them.
Nudariko bafako.
Praying for them.
No wasamira. So say this my ministry ya Pastor Abel ya amai.
I always tell people, start serving God to the people around you.
Chenga wa wantu jotani kila mkuweleza katuenda kuantu wala kwe tolo de. Tono nyabazungu.
Start doing what you can do today.
Tandi kila okuweleza.
And then gradually God will show you strategies. And then when you find a strategy, you can tell me. I will help you to reach that strategy of God. Now, I want to share with you how I grew. Now I want to say that before I experienced the Holy Spirit, I really, you know, I did not have a strategy.
When I was in that jail, my mother told me, "I can't carry my net and jam my finger to somebody. I'm not going to move. I'm going to be here in Angola."
But after I experienced the Holy Spirit, I saw how can I change, how I can change people's spiritual life. I was really excited.
Now we had to see what more you. Now Zula and say, "Hey, yet I go to Yamba and to Blamba, what more you could have." Let's see what's on your.
Because that is something I have always wanted to do, but I find that I could not do it.
Now, it's a little bit of color, me, Yaka, Diridia, so go away, and then I got a sort of watchy. Toyamu, I talk and Amuani.
I spend more time praying.
Now, I would the wounding and Saba.
And I spend, you know, more time loving God and meditating on the Word of God. And I listen to the Bible all day long. And then I start to build up people's spiritual life. And there are some people who respond better. I help them to go higher. I found that by the power of the Holy Spirit, when I pray for people, they can experience God's help and then His joy and love. And I tell them, you can pray for other people. After you handle your problems in your life, you can lay hands on other people. And counsel different people. And also you can handle different problems in your life so that you won't be affected by people or negative experiences. So I start to build up people in the church. In the church where I experienced the Holy Spirit, there were a few missionaries and a few pastors coming out from that church. And after that, God gave me a period of about 10 years to handle my life. So that even when people say negative things in front of me, I have the ability to discern this person has sinful thoughts and he is angry with me. And I can say it doesn't matter. I care about this person. I have compassion on him because he has been hurt by people. But I don't have to be affected by him. I don't have to eat the garbage from his sinful nature. Now this 10 years God built up my quietness in God. My obedience and submission to God. And also different teachings. And then I was set free. And after I was set free, teachings keep coming to me every month. And then when I go to places, I found that, you know, not only my goal is to raise up lay people's spiritual life. God gave me the heart. Even if I raise, you know, pray for people, lay people, and they experience the Holy Spirit and they wanted to serve God. And then if the pastors are not willing to be filled with the Holy Spirit or are not willing to serve God with the power of the Holy Spirit,
Boy, what day you could use my mind, Gamma, and up where is a Katona Mumoyo?
The church will not have a big change. So God guided me to see the pastors are the most important person to change. Now, I'm not saying the change have to change my way. Whatever change you find that will help you to go higher in God's plan, follow that change. Because God has given different revelation from different sources. But we have to discern which one is right, which one is wrong. Which one is good and which one is better and the best? How you can have strategy to raise up people and train them to be powerful. Now in your church, if you have a team like that, once you have this team can have a big influence on the whole church. The life of this team is very important. They have the joy of the Lord. They enjoy the love of God. They handle different problems in their life. They are not chasing after the girls or the guys in the church. They really have the heart on God. And they have good experiences of helping people. Now, if you check on Pastor Yip on YouTube, you'll find that there are many testimonies of people who were changed by the power of God, and I asked them to share and then put it online. Now some of them, you know, they speak Chinese, but you can see that they were giving a testimony. Some of the faces were blurry because they don't want to show their face. It's okay. They're mostly Chinese, but some are English. So when these team members, when they pray for people and their experiences, I will also ask them to share. To encourage this ministry team, they can do great things for God. And then for those who can go higher up, you know, even preaching and leading, then I would give them the opportunity. And I will give them positive response. Suggestions to them. How they can do better. Because they need guidance how to be free. Now you notice also when I preach, you notice my concept 102 is very clear. The concepts are very clear. And you also see that I'm excited in those teachings. So I told my ministry team members, it's very important that you're excited by the Holy Spirit. You have the freedom of the Lord. You have the joy and the love of God. And then you share with an excited voice.